researchers identify drugs that might save people from severe COVID. Inflammation is a natural defense mechanism of the body against infection, yet it can damage the body at extreme levels. In COVID-19, some patients develop such severe inflammation that increases their chances of dying. At the Spanish National Center Research Center, or CNIO, the team investigated what drugs could control COVID-related severe inflammation. The condition known as cytokine storm is associated with COVID-19. When the immune system reacts badly to the coronavirus, inflammatory signals like cytokines typically surge at high levels. Of course, cytokines are needed to fight the virus and stop the infection. However, there's a problem with uncontrolled cytokine production. At high levels, cytokines recruit more immune cells to join the fight at infection sites. That means more infantry to eliminate the virus. If the sites are neutral grounds, it will benefit the body. But infections take place in healthy tissues, and scrambling immune cells that want to join in is bad for tissues. Organs can be damaged by the infighting between immune cells and invaders. If the damage is severe, organ failure will likely follow. Imagine that happening in several vital organs at once. This response is often the cause of death in those affected by SARS-CoV-2, rather than the virus itself, explained study author Oscar Fernandez Capetillo. So, CNIO researchers sought for potential compounds to regulate that kind of inflammatory response. Published in the journal Scientific Reports, the team looked for antidotes using data from COVID patients who died due to cytokine storm. That data included the changes in gene expression linked to the condition. Around 5,000 compounds were identified with the potential to cut down those changes. Of identified compounds, existing MEK protein inhibitors demonstrated a strong anti-inflammatory effect in vitro. These inhibitors are usually part of cancer treatments because they help inhibit tumor growth, though the effects against COVID-related inflammation are only observed. There are more things needed to be known, especially if these inhibitors will be used for a different purpose. But if found safe and effective, many patients may be saved from the deadly downside of severe inflammation during infection, COVID or not. Virtually all the molecules we predicted at the time have been validated in later work by other groups, which is gratifying, researchers said. For the context itself, any anti-inflammatory drugs like glucocorticoids should be given at the later stage of infection. At the early stage, you still need inflammation to support your immune cells. Those drugs will practically toss your immune response out of the window. At the late stage where inflammation still peaks, the drugs can help modulate it. What do you think of repurposing some cancer drugs for COVID-19? Should other scientists investigate further? Share your thoughts in the comment section. Till our next video, thanks for watching.